Hello YouTube, my name is Hero, and today we're going to be discussing the new grind locations in Commonwealth Part 2 and how the Korean community has taken to these places and some reviews we've gotten from the places and what they have to offer. So it's going to take a little bit more time to see pretty much exactly what Koreans feel about these places, but so far we've gotten some mixed reviews. But first let's go in and get in there. Now we're going to start from the lowest level spots to the higher level spots. Now, the lowest level spot is called Poly Forest. Poly Forest is for level 53 to 55, and it's the area that's going to have poison damage as an environmental effect. Now, it is located close by the town Graina, and it's not too far away, and this place is pretty much for lower level players, so you take very little damage from the monsters. It's even lower than Saucons. This is pretty much going to be for people who are level 50 and above that are on their way to getting their awakening. This is for you to get to your awakening. Once you get your awakening, there's really literally no reason for you to be here unless you have extremely low AP values, in which case maybe, but in otherwise no, you'd actually want to go to the next area, and the next area will be known as Ring Tree Forest, Fatus Garrison. This is for level 55 to 57, and this place has been deemed to be a very, 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 very good EXP spot. It's even better than Saucon, but the difficulty is the same. The mobs have very low HP. It's said that even if your AP is anywhere around, say, 170 to 180, you should have no problem being able to kill the monsters with 1, 2, maybe 3 abilities. So it's very good. It's better to grind in a single spot because the monster respawn rate is very high. So apparently it's faster than normal monster respawn rate, which is pretty good. There's some rotations there that are obviously going to be better than others. It's going to be like probably the main rotation, just like there is in any other grind spot. But basically this area is very good from 55 to 57. And I'm sure you can probably stick around till 58. So this is probably going to be the big hot spot, the big new hot spot for everyone who, after they have their awakening, you're going to want to come here. And this is going to pretty much take Saucon off the map, but Saucon will still be viable for those guys, I suppose, who want to stay away from PvP, because this is going to be most likely the highest contested spot in the game for the lower leveled, or not lower level, but mid level players. So the next place we're going to is the Tooth Fairy Forest. Now this place is the place I was telling about that got mixed reviews. The monsters are very powerful and they stay in groups. Your HP will go down a lot. They hit very freaking hard, and the space between monsters is big, so there's only like one group you have to deal with in time. Supposedly they say that it was impossible to grind with a level 57 at 200 AP, 240 DP. So party grinding is strongly recommended in this area. So this is going to be the first place where party grinding is pretty much a necessity for people that don't have those crazy high stats. Keep in mind that this is not the highest stats in the game, and this place is also recommended for people that are level 59 or above. I'm pretty sure you could come here at 57, 58 if you're higher geared with a group though. So this place is probably going to have very good EXP for those higher tier players, a little bit higher tier players in a group, especially if you're lower leveled but you happen to have good gear, maybe making an alt or something like that. So Tooth Fairy Forest is going to be that kind of place. Supposedly it's the furthest away from Graina, so you do have to go back to Graina to dump your storage and things like that if you don't have a storage maid, because it's all the way up north here. But it's still supposedly very good EXP. It's just a few inconveniences, the distance you have to travel, as well as the fact that you need a group if you don't have like super high stats, super high DP and high level. And the last area, which is, like I said, G Shrine, I cannot pronounce the name, but this is the hardest grind spot pretty much in the game currently. It's designed for people who are 60 above with high gear. All monsters have super high DP and HP, but they attack very slow. They say at level 57, someone with 200 AP took them took 4 to 5 minutes to kill the monster. So, and if two or more monsters are attacking someone with those stats, they can only hurt their guard for 1 second. So that's incredible. They have very high AP and attack speed. They have very high AP and HP, but their attack speed is very slow. So you can easily dodge the attacks, but this place is just very, very strong. And this is the only place, supposedly so far, where the new set Lemuria can be looted at. So it's probably going to be, by the time you get here, you won't need it anymore. So it's kind of weird that you can loot it here. But I would think that this set would have been dropped from mobs. I mean, from bosses, but it actually is dropped from these mobs. So it's actually not recommended to grind for money here yet, but once again, this area is rather new and this is going to take a lot of in-game players to come together, which we all know they don't really like to do, in order to figure out if this place is going to be pretty much good enough for everything and things like that. And a little bit extra info about the Lemuria set. It is a blue set that cannot be upgraded. It's kind of just like a Laverto, a part of his piece. It's like Laverto armor, if you think of it that way. And it also only has 1 gem slot. So while it is very good and obviously the best piece of gear you can get outside of boss gear, it's still not insanely OP. So don't get it misunderstood. You definitely can keep your Grunail if you want to. You don't have to upgrade to this set, but it is highly recommended, I'd say, that you do once it comes to the game and is actually obtainable reasonably well. Obviously, you will need to use memory fragments or another piece of the gear to upgrade it for the Lemuria set. So that's pretty much it so far, guys. That's pretty much all the information we have for Common Civ Part 2, the Koreans. So far, still checking it out. It's still too soon to say if it's going to be the king, the knockdown saucing and pirates for that late game grinding and money. We don't know how much money you can get per hour from these places either. That's yet to be talked about. The EXP actually seems to be pretty good, though, especially at the mid-level area. That's gonna pretty much replace Saucin in terms of experience, but experience isn't everything. Money is also very important in this game, as I'm sure you all know. So we'll have to wait and see if that area actually supplies the player with enough money to pretty much make it reasonable not to go back to Sauce and the Pirates anymore. But yeah, guys, just quick update for you. Hope you guys enjoyed the content. If you did, hit me with a like. Make sure you subscribe. It's your boy Hero. See you guys next time. Peace.